homosexuality. That's all they're doing. The whole world religion. All this goes against God. They're doing that. First of all, the Tower of Babel. The word Babylon comes from Babel. Babel means confusion. That's why this place is Babylon. Because it's full of confusion. And plus, this is where they get all they stuff from. From Egypt, Babylon, the Chaldeans. All this wicked stuff that they do is ancient. It ain't nothing. The white man has nothing to do. He done stole everything that he do. That's why people think that Christianity and Egyptology is the same thing. Because all the white people, it is the same thing. It's all paganism. When the white man, Alexander, the Greek, took over the world, he took Egypt. After he died, he split the world up amongst his four generals. And his general Ptolemy took Egypt. And that Ptolemy was white. Cleopatra was white. That's the daughter of him. You know what I'm saying? Those people were white. So when Julius Caesar got with Cleopatra, that was two white people getting together because they ruled Egypt just like right now. Those white Muslims that's ruling Egypt, it's the same thing. The real Egyptians that were there got struck down by the Most High. They living in the Sudan now. The Lord said he was going to strike them down, take them out. He did that. Now it's other people ruling that land, just like this thing. One of the natives, our brothers, ruling this land, they got struck down too because they went against God. So, all this go together, man. You just gotta know what's going on. The goddamn white man is crap.
So, I got a question though. He ain't even like, bro, like, if you're right, they experience it. Like, even like a practical level, like, which I think we need to start doing. Like, just a little practical still.
Give me
a lot of people, like, if you try to bring this to them, it's gonna go in one ear, out the other, they go in their business. I've been sitting there talking to some of my homies back in the club. Like, you want to start off by having, like, get together. A lot of people come into your house, feed them, give them good music to listen to.
And it's 7-9-2-1. This, what we doing, Rob, we doing it is a change of pace. Is this different from your first experience with the Israelites?
I mean, my first experience, it was too quick. It was, like, 20 seconds. I was really just saying, what's up? It's different. Yeah. I didn't really get challenged.
Chapter 2, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Gather yourselves together.
What did the Lord say?
Gather yourselves together.
Uh-huh.
Ye gather together, O nation not desired.
You want to bring me a nation not desired? The Lord knows this already. The other nations just want our money. They don't want to do nothing with us. They want to take our money. They ain't going to do no community outreach. They ain't going to build no schools in our community. They ain't going to build no grocery stores that's going to benefit us. Because we up under them. So the Lord told us to gather ourselves together. Not deal with them, we got to deal with us. And if we deal with us, we'll be all right. Read on.
Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the shaft, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
He's telling us to gather ourselves together before the day of the Lord's anger come back on us. That's what we're doing right now. We the nation not desired. See, when Martin Luther King did what he did with the Civil Rights Movement, that set us back. Because as you see, do we have any swords in our community? You go to any black neighborhood, the majority of it is going to be owned by the Asians, the Arabs, the Africans, and the white man. Because when we did that, we sold ourselves out to be with everybody else. Now, didn't the Lord say, come out of her? They don't know how to read the Bible. Come out of this wicked country. There's nowhere in the world you can prove that this country's not wicked. This country ain't nothing but wicked. But you want to be a part of this country? The country that's against the black man? The country that's promoting homosexuality? The country that's promoting interracial relationships? The country that's promoting the black woman over us? I want to be a part of that? This country don't represent me.
It's basically reverse psychology. You know what I'm saying? It's like you had something that I want. But, you know, I got something that you have interest in, too.
But we gotta be smarter than that, man. That's what the prophets is out here for. The Lord is telling us everything we need to do. We need to come together. But when we did the Civil Rights Movement, we went to go work with them and went to go be in their schools, then our schools were neglected. Can't in our grocery stores is neglected. In our corner stores is neglected. You know what I'm saying? Now we don't got enough. Because the black people with the money want to go be amongst the white people. They don't want to spend the money in the black neighborhoods no more. They think they too good now. That's what it's called, Puma. You know what I'm saying? I got a book right here. The Miseducation of the Negro. Of what's wrong with us. But the Bible really tells it all. It tells you why. Why we like this. Why we can't work together. Why we don't get along. But if you come back to your God, the God of Israel, and do what he say, give me Psalms 111 and 10. You're going to understand this Bible if you do what the Bible says. Two greatest commandments in the scriptures is love God and love your brothers as you love yourself, right? Hold that. Hold that. Give me love. 1 John 5. Because they don't teach our people this. In that Ethiopian church, do they teach you how to love God?
Yeah. They taught me how to love them.
I'm talking about how to love.
I got there.
How to love God. Your God. First of all, what God is they serving?
Yahweh.
Yeah, that don't mean nothing. What God? We know what God we serve. You know what I'm saying? I need your help, because I'm going to be trying to do some stuff. He got it. Read that.
Book of 1 John, chapter 5, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
For this is the love of God.
This is the love of the God of Israel. Because God is not the God of everybody, even though everybody going to bow a knee. He's dealing with the Israelites. Everybody else gets to run rampant right now. And they treat the Israelites like shit. But it's our own fault. Because we went against our God, because we stopped loving him. Read.
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
Keep his commandments.
Uh-huh.
And his commandments are not grievous.
His commandments are not grievous. His commandments are not hard. All we got to do is come back to doing thus saith the Lord. I was in Christianity. He was in Christianity. You was in Christianity? Muslim, Islam, Catholic. That's a woo, that's deep.
Right.
But when you open the Bible and see, all right, they go to Christianity, then I'll be in that church here. Here's what the Bible says. My grandmama don't know what she doing. You know what I'm saying? That pastor don't know what the hell he talking about. You know what I'm saying? So you got to be a man and realize just because you was brought up, that's the traditions of man. You going to do traditions of man or you going to do the word of God? Give me Acts. 5:29. Acts 5:29. This is what it boiled down to. Are you gonna do the traditions of man, or are you gonna do the word of God? You don't need no man to hover over you to do the word of God. You know what I'm saying? Anybody got that? Read. Acts 5:29. This is what we out here showing our people, man. It's simple. They making it be all that stuff that the Catholic Church do. They're not doing that because it's Bible, because God told us not to do none of that shit, man. All them statues and all that rituals and all that different stuff that they doing, that's not in here. Read on.
The book of Acts, chapter 5 and verse 29.
Uh-huh.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God.
We should do what?
Obey God.
We should do what?
Obey God.
Uh-huh.
Rather than man.
That is the difference. When you go to church, listen to the man, because that dude is there for the The man don't know what you're talking about. He might have talked to himself. Read that.
Book of Luke, chapter 1, verse 69. And has 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Who?
Lord God of Israel.
Of who?
Lord God of Israel.
Read on.
For he had visited and redeemed his people.
Bruh, an Ethiopian can't teach you about the Lord God of Israel, bro. It ain't happening. He condemning the Ethiopians. You know what I'm saying? They cannot teach you, this is not their God. This is not their book. The white man can't teach you his book. The white, this is not their God. If it was their God, why would they put a white man up when it's clear as day in two scriptures that Christ is a man of color?
Right.
This has nothing to do with them. This is what we teach in our world. Read that again. Oh, give me that.
book of Malachi, chapter 2 and verse 7.
This is what a real priest, preacher, minister, apostle, disciple, evangelist, or whatever somebody want to call themselves that work for the Most High going to do. Read.
For the priest's lips shall keep knowledge.
Now, we done went through knowledge, remember? We went through knowledge. Read on.
And they should seek the law.
They should do what?
Seek the law.
Uh-huh.
At his mouth.
They should keep the law at the priest's mouth. You know,
for he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts.
So if somebody's saying they the messenger of the Lord, of the God of Israel, he's going to teach you the law, statutes, and commandments of God. Point blank, period. Give me that up in the time.
Book of St. John, chapter 2 and verse 3.
And we equipping y'all with the tools to understand how to see through some bullshit. Because the man of the Lord is going to do this, bro. The man of the Lord is going to be your brother, an Israelite,
from
one of the 12 tribes, and he's going to be telling you the God of Israel said that you need to keep the law, statutes, and commandments of God. If he's not doing that, he's not working for Yahweh Shah and the Most High. Read.
Book of 1 John, chapter 2 and verse 3.
Uh-huh.
And hereby we do know that we know him.
Or so somebody saying they know the God of Israel.
If we keep his commandments.
If we do what?
If we keep his commandments.
They out on the Sabbath, two-step people. Or is they in Sunday worship church? They got a beard on their face? Or is they booty face in Egyptian ball here? You know what I'm saying? Freedom.
He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments.
If he ain't even trying to keep the commandments, he's still eating pork. But he's saying he working for the Most High. Nigga, you can put some pork down. You do not have to eat no pork. You make yourself go in the grocery. When we was in slavery, that's what they gave us. We was in slavery, in shadow slavery. Now it's mental slavery. So physically, you don't have to go buy no pork. But you be in the Exodus 20, not to eat pork. I mean, the Exodus, not to eat pork. What is it, Exodus 7 and 7? Read on.
Is a liar, and the truth is not in him.
So he say he know God, and he not keeping his commandments. The Bible says he's what?
Is a liar.
He's a what?
Is a liar.
He's a what?
Is a liar.
You know?
And the truth is not in him.
And the truth is not in him, bro. And the truth is the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God.
That's right.
Christ is the truth. And if you tell them the truth about Christ, then you're going to get in Revelation 2014. If they're going to tell the truth about Christ, you got to say what the Bible say, what he looked like. You know what I'm saying? Give me Hebrews 11. They gonna teach you these laws, man. The brother saying, I don't care who he is. Trump, look out, TD snakes. If they are supposed to be a so-called Israelite, a so-called black man.
Y'all like TD snakes?
He's a sellout, man. He's a sellout against his people. If you're doing prosperity gospel, that's what's wrong. What the scriptures say you should be doing. Is he teaching the laws of God? Oh, he's a good motivational speaker.
That's right.
But the day that you put a cross-dressing, Tyler Perry,
yeah,
up on your stage and let him lay hands on you because he gave you $1 million check, you is a sellout, man.
That's right.
You not working for the Most High because Christ told the disciples to go out with nothing. You don't need nothing. You're going to earn your keep by doing his work. So if you working for money, you not working for God. Christ didn't work for no money, so how you better than Christ? You know what I'm saying? They can say, oh, it's the church, he makes his own money. Man, we know the game. We take that tax exemption from the government, it's things that you can't preach about. It's things that you can't go against the government about. You know what I'm saying? It's the 501c3. So if you go sign up with the government for a 501c3 so you can be tax exempt for the money, you're not working for the Lord, man.
That's right.
We don't need no money.
Working for the government.
We don't want no money.
So was it not the government through slavery? Set us up in the Roman Empire? Did it not happen to the Roman Empire? So who said it? Who brought us in this so-called idea of ourselves? We didn't come up with it ourselves, so we're just going to stop being Israelites and we're going to be niggas.
Give me Psalms 82.
Then we got
Psalms 83.
Forward to 1985. 88, Jesse Jackson started calling me African American. I was born before that. I'm older than my so-called lineage. My lineage predates you. So if my lineage predates me as an Israelite, that is the only lineage I know that predates me as a being a man of color. But being in this country, being a so-called African American, that's telling you you're the product of two white dudes.
Yeah.
Leo Scipio's Africanus. The miracle of execution. Who was an Italian name?
abrogated that so-called discovered America. The one was the Roman general that conquered what we know today as Africa, which is the ancient days. This is Grant
Council. You're going to bring that out too? Read that out. Keep right on point.
Book of Psalms, chapter 83, verse 2. For lo, thine enemies make it true.
That's David telling God by enemies. He said, your enemies is making a mad confusion. Read on.
And they that hate thee have lifted up thee head.
Bruh, it's people on this planet that hate the Most High God of Israel, bro.
Right.
Because God chose the Israelites and not them. The white man hate God, the God of Israel. It's only one God. The Asian man hate the God. You know what I'm saying? That's why they worship other gods. Why is there so many multiple gods? Where they at? It's only one creator. He told us how the world got created. He told us where we all come from. He told us what we supposed to be doing. Where they book to say the same thing? They ain't got it. That's why they got to come back to this book. That's why the Muslims use this book. Why do they use this book? Because they book is garbage, man. The Quran is talking about the children of Israel from the beginning to the end of it, bro.
That's right.
The Quran is talking about the children of Israel. And do you know it talks about Christ? Abraham, Isaac, Moses? Huh. Because they going off this book. Because everybody come from Africa. Everybody come from Africa. Give me we got to finish reading that. Let's read that.
Psalms 83, verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel.
They have did what?
Taken crafty counsel against thy people.
These people have taken crafty counsel against us. Look at it. I'm going to show you the scriptures in real life. Who on that story?
Probably an Arabic or African.
Take some fish. Oh, they got fish. The chicken and seafood, I know that's lame. The star, the cute nail. The beef supply, we know that's Asian. What's the dollar store at the end? That's not?
Who is it?
See, Africa. That's ham. Mm-hmm. Okay, you got to pin down. But is it our people? Huh? Who?
I look at it as our people. What we're talking about now, it does then you.
Tabernacles of Edom.
That's the white man.
That's
all the 18 nations in the Bible is right here. The cipher to who they are today. Eat it. They know.
Give me the baby book too.
We finna show you that they know who they are, and now we know who we are.
So, the tabernacles of Edom, right?
We know Edom comes from Esau. Esau is the father of the Edomites, right?
This right here says, according to commentaries of Hebrew scripture, Esau is considered a significant character in world history and the forefather of the Roman Empire, right? It's another book.
The Roman Empire. The Empire of the Edomites. The Edomites is the so-called white man, which he's not white, he's red. Yeah. Have you ever seen a white man this color? Yeah. But you've seen them all this color. Yeah. Different shades of red. The white man is Esau. The Edomites, that's their biblical nationality. Read on.
The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites.
The Ishmaelites are the Arabs. That's the Arab man.
Right here.
It's the Arab man. So we got the white man and the Arab man in confederate against the freedom
of Moab.
Moab is the Chinese man. All Asians not the same. Some of them come from Moab, some of them come from Ammon. But the Chinese come from Moab. Just pointed them out in these shots. Freedom.
Hagarenes.
Those were the Egyptians. Let me show you something. I need ham.
Which Egyptians though? You know, you got white ones and the black ones.
The black ones. Because they two different, just like the Mexicans, right? Just like the Mexicans. In Mexico, you got white Mexicans, you got brown Mexicans, right?
Spaniards and Aztecs.
Exactly, you know that. So that's because
there is still, but just because there's Spaniards and Aztecs, there's still another breed in there. That's what they call an Afro-Mexican.
Oh, yeah.
These are the Negroes. This is what we're, these are the people we're speaking.
The Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. Bam.
The youngest son of Noah, born probably about 96 years before the flood, and one of the eight persons to live through the flood.
Bam. So Noah had three sons, right, after the flood. Ham, Shem, and Japheth. We're talking about Ham.
He became the progenitor of the dark races.
So Ham became the progenitor of the dark races. People with melanin.
Not the Negroes.
Not who?
Not the Negroes.
Not the Negroes. We're the Negroes. But who?
But the Egyptians.
Uh-huh.
Ethiopians.
Uh-huh.
Lebanon.
Uh-huh.
Canaanites.
Uh-huh.
That's all.
Yeah. So Ham is the father of the so-called Africans today. They Hamites. Yeah. We're not Hamites. That's why I pointed out, read this to this brother.
Good, brother. Well, appreciate you.
Read this to the brother.
Appreciate it.
And give me Exodus 20 and 8. We're showing the brother that we're not Africans.
Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. This is Ham. So it shows you the difference between us and the other nations that have that so-called melanated people. Okay, so just because we all have the same tones in our skin, don't mean we're the same people. They've been fooling us for years with that, but the Bible's clarifying that for us. The book of Ham, the youngest son of Noah, born probably 96 years before the flood, and one of the eight persons to live through the flood. He became the progenitor of the dark race, not the Negroes.
Not the Negroes. Who are the Negroes?
They stopped calling us Negroes. Because see, they were still telling us who we were. So they had to come up with another word to start calling us. You see what I'm saying? That's why in slavery, the word nigger was used as a name. Everybody thought that the other brother's name was nigger. You see what I'm saying?
This is crap. You ain't never seen them say African. They never said that.
Right there. Negroes.
That's an actual breakdown of the sales certificate for our ancestors on the Oxford.
Well, Africans sold us to the white man. The white man never came into the interior of Africa. That's why it's called the Slave Coast. Because we was warring with the Africans. They knew who we were. And we knew who they were. So whenever we lost to them, they rounded us up and took us to the coast. And the white man put us on the ship and brought us over here.
Right.
We're not the same people. That's why these people don't even interact with us like
that. Right. Yeah. You can look at the appearance features. You know, face, your body, way to walk, way to talk. You can tell 100 that they're not us.
Yeah, of course, to the white man, we are. But in reality, we're not. We different people, man. You know what I'm saying? How the hell we Africans when all the Africans is different? It's 52 countries on the continent of Africa. How the hell is we just Africans? You know what I'm saying? What country we come from? We come from many countries out of Africa. It's not just one country. We spread a whole region. We was powerful, man. So when we say we kings and queens and stuff like this, we were.
That's right. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue, against man or beast, that ye may know,
but you don't know,
how that the Lord doeth put a difference between the Egyptians and Israel.
The Lord put a difference between the Egyptians and Israel. You know what I'm saying? Let's show you the difference. It's a slave coast. Let me show you this one. See that? That was Negro land. All they called is Negro land. Because we occupied all this. To the point where they called it Negro land. You know what I'm saying? And then we zoom in. Coast. Where they took us from, the slave coast. It's called the slave coast. You know what I'm saying? And right here is the kingdom of Judah. We had a kingdom there. Us. We had a kingdom there. They knew this. This is where they took us from. You know what I'm saying? So we can go right back wider. Once you get to translating these words, like if you don't know, you don't know. If you don't know, you Judah, then you don't even know to look for it. So if you're looking at this and you see wider, you don't know that that's Judah in another language. If you see Oguda, you don't know that that's Judah in French. You know what I'm saying?